the bubbly.
Pour like there's no tomorrow. You are getting your husband back.
I'm so happy. Of course, I feel bad for April.
Why? She should have known what was coming. This is how the movie always ends. The man slinks back to his wife and the whore ends up drunk and alone. Actually, now that I got four kids, it doesn't sound so bad.
I was thinking of taking April to a restaurant next week. You know, to cheer her up.
Beth Ann, the war is over. You won. Let the enemy limp away in defeat.
April and I grew very close these last few weeks. It's a true friendship.
She thinks your name is Sheila.
I admit, it's a complicated...
Honey, what's wrong?
April is in my driveway. Shit! What is she doing here?
Why the fuck should I know?
We can't open the door.
I think we're gonna have to. I think she saw me.
You have to be me.
Are you crazy?
Please, I'm begging.
Fine. Christ on a cracker.
Don't swear. And be nice.
May I help you?
Are you Mrs. Robert Stanton?
Yes. And who might you be, pray tell?
I'm April. I'm a waitress at Jansen's Diner in Glendale. Your husband is one of my regulars.
Is he?
Yes.
I don't mean to rush you, dear, but I have curtains to hem and croutons in the oven.
Yes, I just wanted to come by to say that I think your husband might have left his coat at the diner.
Well, mercy me.
I'm not even sure if it's his, but if you wouldn't mind just telling him that I stopped by and asking him to call me.
He knows your number? Number?
At the diner. He could just give me a call at the diner.
I'll tell him. Bye now.
Goodbye.
I have never said mercy me.
But you do. Bake your own croutons.
I can't believe April actually came to the house.
Gotta say, I'm impressed. That tramp, she ain't going down without a fight.
Well, this tramp isn't either. You know what I mean?